Hello everyone, this is Raman Rana here, your mathematics teacher, Cambridge International School, Dasua. Today we will again discuss chapter number 17, the topic area under a speed time graph. The area under the speed time graph gives the distance traveled, and we will solve the revision worksheet also.
Dear students, yesterday we have discussed chapter number 17. We have discussed in detail the speed, distance and time. We have taken some questions based on speed, distance and time. Chapter 17, it was a straight line graph. So let's recapitulate the straight line graph. Straight line graph we have discussed the graph speed time graph we have discussed the gradient we have also discussed the travel graph and in that the gradient that represents the speed of an object while traveling. So we have also discussed the acceleration in a travel graph also. In travel graph we have discussed that distance is the time t and here is the distance. So small, that is a time and the distance. So the gradient we have discussed, that is d upon t. So it represents the speed, that is gradient always in meter per second. So the gradient represents the speed of the object with which it is traveling. Now today we will discuss the area under the speed time graph. The main topic which we will take today, that is the area under the speed time graph. So dear students, this is important one, the area under the speed time graph, because this area under speed time graph determine the distance traveled by the object. So we'll take some example from the book and then we will discuss the complete revision worksheet which we have given yesterday. Let's take the example. In this example, a table is given, an object moving with the speed in beginning it is 20 meter per second, and at 5 seconds again it is 20 meter per second, and at 10 seconds 15, 20, 25 and 30 seconds, and the speeds, respective speed is given. So we need to find, first plot the speed time graph, second acceleration after 10 seconds, and the third one, calculate the distance traveled in 30 seconds. Complete distance traveled in the 30 seconds. So here along y-axis it is a speed meter per second, and along x-axis time. So for 0, 5, 10 up to 10 seconds the speed is constant, that is 20 So up to here, the speed will remains the same. So now from here, the speed start that increasing. Now the speed is 22 meter per second, then 22.5, 20, 27.5, 30. So time also accordingly here 30, we have the time here. So and the speed is increasing uniformly, 2.5, 2.5, 2.5 after every 5 seconds. So the graph will be a straight graph. So from here, we generally take the coordinates. So here, when you are solving, you will use the grid. So in grid, it is very easy. So here, this is the graph for the speed time graph for this table. Now we have the second part, that is acceleration. And it is given, the second part, that acceleration after 10 seconds. So acceleration after 10 seconds, we know the acceleration at 10 seconds, that is, so here we have half per second square. Units, please remember the units, that half meter per second square. Now the third part, that is very important, to find the distance, total distance traveled here. So here, if I am joining this line, because the total distance, to find the total distance, we need to find the area. That is, rectangle is area A, and this triangle, which is a right angle triangle, that is the portion B of this graph. So area under the speed time graph represents the distance traveled by the object. So here the third part, that is the total distance traveled, the distance traveled that is area A. Area A is equal to, here length is 30 units and the width is 20. So area is 30 into 20 meters, that is equal to 600 meters. Whereas this shaded area, 's right angle triangle P, we need to find here the coordinates of two points. Let me discuss here with you. Here the coordinates are 10 and 20, and here again 30, 20, and here also the coordinates are 30 and. So the area of the right angle triangle, this triangle, the portion B is equal to base. This is the base and this is the height. I am taking this point as A, this point is, or take a point P here, P, Q, R. So PQ is equal to, total distance is 30. So this distance is 20. So area of right angle triangle is half into base. Base is 20 and height, this height is 10 here. This height is 10 and here this distance is 20. So we have this distance 100 meter. So the distance traveled for this table, this observation, that is area A plus area B. So it is 600 meter plus 100 meter, which is equal to 700 meter. So total distance traveled in this example is 700 meter. So I hope you are clear with this example. Let's start with the revision exercise question number 1. Question number 1. Here the graph is given, the speed time graph is given, and we have to find the total distance traveled. So here in this graph we have the time after 3 seconds, the speed that is reached by the object is 12 meter per second, and after 3 seconds to 10 seconds that speed remains the same, that is 12 meter per second, and then it start decreasing and become 0 at 15 seconds. So to find the total distance traveled, total distance traveled by the object is equal to the area under the speed time graph. So area here we have the two triangles, let this triangle is A, this portion here, shaded area. This is a, then here also we have one more triangle, that is again a right angle triangle, and then we have the rectangular portion here, this rectangular portion. So this is a total area under the speed time graph. So here the total distance, that is the area under the portion A plus B plus C. So here the area of A, the area A is equal to half, base is 3 and height is 12. So here this area is equal to 18 meter, whereas this area B, the area B is equal to area of a rectangle is length into width. So here this length is 7 and the height is, this width is 12. So the area here, that is 7 into 12, which is equal to 84. And we have the third portion, that is again a right angle triangle. Here that this is the B portion and this is the C part. So we have one is A portion is 18, whereas the B, that is 84, and the third one, that the C part, is again a right angle triangle. Half for a right angle triangle, base is 5 and height is 12 again. This height is 12 here. This height is 12 here. So same. So here we have, that is 30. So the total distance traveled by the object is here, this is 12 and here we have 132 meters. So we have 132 meters. The distance traveled by the object, this graph shows that the object traveled the total distance of 132 meters. Question number 2. Again, the speed time graph for the journey of a car, and again we have to calculate the total distance traveled by the car. So here, after 20 seconds, car attains speed of 12.5 meter per second, and then from 20 seconds to 220 seconds, that speed remains the same, and after 220 seconds, the speed that decreasing the acceleration, and at 280 again the car stops. So we have to find the total journey. So again we have two right angle triangles A and C, and B is the this rectangle portion. So we will find these areas. So here the shaded area represents the total distance traveled. So total distance traveled is equal to the area A plus B plus C here. So area A here, that is base is 20, that is half base is 20, height is 12.5. So we have 125 meters plus B. Now this distance from here to here, this distance is now 200, and height is again 125. So area B is equal to 200 into 12.5. So here we have 10 here, 5 to the 10. 5 to the 10, 2 to the 4 plus 1, 5, and again we have 2 ones are 2, and again this distance here is 60, this distance from here to here, this is 60 units, and this is again 12.5. so area C is half, base is 60, height is again 12.5. so this is 30 here, so this one is 375. So total here, that is 2500 plus the area of the this C rectangle, that is 375. So in meters, we are taking the units in meters. So here we have total it is 3000 meters, or which is equal to 3 kilometers. So same first and second questions both are same. We have to calculate the total distance traveled. So in this question number 2, the car travels the total distance, that is 3 kilometers. Question number 3, for a train journey, the speed time graph is given. For the 60 seconds, we have to find first the acceleration of the train, and the second the distance traveled, and that to be kilometers. So here, first part, that is acceleration, so here time that is 60, and here that is the 15 units. So that is 4 meter per second square. So acceleration here is 4 meter per second square is the acceleration. Now the second part is the distance. So we know the area under the graph, this area, that is right angle triangle, here base, that is 60, and the height is 15. So the distance traveled by the train in 60 seconds is equal to half, base is 60 and height in this case is 15. So here we have, so that is meters, but the answer is asked how much distance it travels in kilometers. So we will convert 450 meters into kilometers. So the total distance, that is equal to 450 upon 1000 kilometer. So which is equal to 0.450 kilometer, or it is less than half kilometer. So this is all about question number 3. Question number 4. Here a distance time graph for the journey of 65 minutes of a bicycle journey in 4 different parts, part A, B, C and D. So here we have to tell in the first part that from these A, B, C, D, these portion part of the journey, which part of the journey is having the fastest speed. And second part, that is after the 65 seconds, if the bicycle travels at the constant speed of 20 km per hour for 15 minutes, so we have to draw the graph for this journey. So here, it is very important to apply these the coordinate geometry concept here. So here again, the speed, that is distance upon time. So here speed for the A part, the speed, the distance traveled, that is 10 kilometers, and the time is, and time here, that is if we check on the graph, it is 15 here. So we have the speed, that is 2 by 3 kilometer per minute, that is near about 0.66 bar or 66, that is kilometer per minute. Whereas for the B part, B portion here, the time, it is here near about 35. So the distance here, that is 20, and this distance is 18 here. So we have 18 minus 10, that is 8. So 8 upon 20. Yes. So again, we have 4, 2 is 8, and 4, 5 is, so this is near about 0.4. Yes, 0.4 kilometer per minute. Whereas the C portion, that is with the constant speed of, that the distance here is 45. Here the, as it is the distance time graph, so here the distance travel is 0. So 0 divided by the time here, that is again we have 10, so it is 0 kilometer. So it is in rest, whereas the D part here, this is 45. So, and here this portion is 65 here. So the speed is equal to here, that the distance, that is 18 to here, it is 23. So the difference is 5, and the interval here is 20, so which is again 1/4. So 1/4 is 0.25 kilometer per minute. So here it is evident from the values that the A part, this speed is the fastest speed, whereas the second part, if we have to draw a graph after 65 seconds, if the speed of the bicycle is 20 km per hour for 15 minutes, so we can change the hours into minutes. So here we have 20, we are traveling 16 minutes. In 16 minutes, the bicycle is traveling 20 km. So in 1 minute, unitary method we are applying. So here, that is 20 upon 60, and in 15 minutes we have 20 upon 60 into 15. So 5 ones are 5, 4, so this is 5. So 5 unit, that is 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, the 5 units. So from here, 15 minutes we have 5 up to, that is 80. So here we have to, this is the time interval, this is the 15 minutes slot, and in 15 minutes the bicycle will travel 5 kilometers. 5 kilometers, it is already at 23, so 5 is 28. So on grid we can, so here I hope you got it. We have to join the B part, this is the graph for the B part. So here it represents that the bicycle travels this journey with the constant speed of 20 km per hour for the 15 minutes. Here it is 65, and from 65 to 50 is 80, that is 15 minutes interval. Question number 5 here. We need to plot here the speed time graph. If a car passes from a check post, if the check post is at origin and it travels for 10 seconds with a constant speed of 8 meter per second, and then it decreases with its speed, with a constant speed for up to 55 seconds. So we have to plot the graph, and then we have to calculate the total distance traveled. So here for first 10 seconds, the speed in here is and after 10 seconds up to 55 seconds here, the car start decreasing its speed, that is with a constant speed. So here we have this speed time graph, and to find the total distance traveled, we have again two triangles, triangle A, triangle B. The distance traveled here, that is A plus B. So A here is half base, that is 10 into 8, that is again 40 here, and the B part, that this is 55, that is 45 means minus 10 is 45. Now it is again 8, half into, that is 45 into 8. So we have, that is 180. So here we have 220 meter. So the distance traveled by the car in 55 seconds, that is 220 meters. Question number 6 is, so car travels a distance of 1280 meters at a constant speed of 64 kilometer per hour, then in how much time the car will travel this distance, and we have to find the time in seconds. So here, better to change the speed in meters. 64 kilometers can be written as, and hours we know, seconds 3600, 16 to 60, 1 hour 60 minutes and further 60 seconds. So here this is about the speed. So we know that 64 kilo, that in 36 seconds unitary method we can apply here, that in 1 hour the car travels with the speed of meters, or we want to find the time, so we can write down in this form that 64,000 meter can be traveled in the time seconds. So 1 meter distance can be traveled in the time, and 1280 meter distance can be traveled 3600 upon 64000. So here we have 0 cancelled, and here we have 64 ones are 64, 64 twos are, so we have 36 into 2, that is 72 seconds. So the car will take 72 seconds to complete 1280 meters distance. In question number 7, the graph is given, speed time graph. In first, we have to find the deacceleration during the first 20 seconds. Then we have to find the total distance traveled in 120 seconds. And then we have to find the average speed. So again here, that deacceleration, that is equal to your the time interval, that is 20 and here the distance that is, the speed that is 8. So here we have 10, 4, 2.5 meter per second square. So next, the total distance traveled, that is area under the graph. So we have this one first, this is the rectangle here, one right angle triangle, and similarly here this is the another right angle triangle. So here the area under the graph, that is 10 into 120, that is total distance traveled. So here 10 into 100, that is 1200 meter plus base, half into base into height, that is half, base is 20, height is 8, so this is 80. Similarly here 90, that is 30 here, so this distance here is 30, and again the height is 10, so the area is half into 30 into 10, so we have, this is 50, that is 150. So here 80 plus 150, so which is equal to 1200 plus 230, and here it is 1430. That is the total distance traveled by the car. Now the last part, that is the average speed. We know that the average speed is the total distance traveled upon total time taken here. Total time taken is, here is 120. So divided by 120 here. So it is near about 12 ones are 12. It is 2 again, 12 ones are 12. And here it is 11. So it is near about 11. That is meter per average speed is 11 meter per second. You can divide, and the average speed is total distance traveled upon total time. So last question is, the Fred travel a distance of 381 kilometer in 2 hours and 18 minutes. He then drive 75 kilometer at a constant speed of 30 kilometer per hour. Calculate the average speed for the whole journey. So here we have the distance, total distance here, the total distance, that is 381 plus 75. So here it is 456 kilometer. We know, we want to find here the average speed. Average speed here, so which is equal to total distance traveled upon total time. So here we have a total distance, and to find the total time, we have already, for this journey, we have 2 hours 18 minutes. And we will calculate for 75 kilometer how much time will take at the speed of 30 kilometer per hour. So here we know that the time is equal to distance upon speed. So here it is 75 upon 30. So here we have the time, that is 0, 3 2s are 6, 3 5s are 15 hours. So it is very important here that 2.5 hours means 2.5 hours. So if we want to write in minutes, so time is 2 hours and 30 minutes. So the total time for the journey, that is equal to 2 hours 18 minutes and 2 hours 30 minutes. So here we have 4 hours and it is 48 minutes. So better to convert here these minutes into hours. So here we know that 48 minutes is equal to 4 upon 5 hours. So we have the total time we have, total time is equal to your 4 into, which can be equal to 24 upon 5 hours. So here the average speed, that is equal to 456 upon 24 upon 5. So we will multiply here 5 here, and we can go for the multiplication here, that 1456 upon 24 ones are 24 here, it is 1 again, 2, 6. So here we have the average speed is equal to 95 kilometers per hour. This is the average speed. So this is all about the last question, that is the average speed of the whole journey, that is 95 kilometer per hour. So dear students, go for these kind of questions. I hope you understood how to find the question, solve the questions based on the distance, speed and time, and how to solve or how to draw the distance time graph, the speed time graph, and how to calculate the distance. So thank you very much. Stay safe, stay healthy.